understand, whenever you want to use this portable knowledge, I don't have a problem. You are free to use. Many people ask me, all these meditation techniques, can I teach for others? I tell you, you are free to use. It's not my property. Property of Buddha, Shakra, Mahavira, Krishna. You have full freedom to teach. I don't have a problem. Then somebody gave me a big list of all the classes they attend. Sudhir there? Oh, please be seated. You can take all this knowledge, whoever wants can use. I have no problem. I am clearly segregating the people who are here for portable knowledge and the people who are here for non-portable experience. People want non-portable experience. Moreover, when you receive non-portable experience, really you feel like committing with your whole life. You won't even feel it, it will just happen. When you close your eyes, start meditating, you will be just sitting with your regular life and dress. When you open your eyes, suddenly you see, you are with mala and bracelet. It just happens. All I feel, let us accept and acknowledge, pay gratitude to each one's contribution. Each one's contribution. When you are given Gayatri, you will be given new name. Do you know all Brahmanas? And if you receive the Gayatri formally, you will be given a new name during the Gayatri initiation. See, it's like that. When you are initiated, you are a new being, new person. That is why you are given new name. It is from Vedic tradition. My age is 17. I can't change. Who? Rohit Shastri? When you became 18, take the name. I am going to be here quite a long time. Don't worry. You'll have fun. Coming to the young age to the masters, master is the best thing can happen to your life. So much of suffering can be avoided. So much of suffering can be avoided. You live differently in different times, sometimes far away from reach, sometimes very near in your heart, sometimes very womanly in appearance. Is it my view in which I look at you or anything else? An enlightenment happens. Physically you may be male or female, but in the being level you go beyond. Understand? Enlightened being is neither male nor female or gay. He is beyond all the three. It's like a, how I hold the kerchief and drop it when I don't want. I'm holding this body. So just because I hold this kerchief, you think that this kerchief has become male or female now? No. It is just an object. Same way, the master's body also becomes a simple object through which he relates. That's all. Sometime, whatever you want to see, you will see. That's all. Sometime you will see Rama, Krishna, Govinda, whoever you want to see. Whatever you are praying, you will see that. During meditation, the last session, you suddenly appeared and stood on my navel center. When I was concentrating on it, being standing there for a few minutes, followed by Lord Shiva, who persisted in all chakras for the rest of the meditation, I couldn't believe it and felt blessed. Ranganathan, wonderful experience. Only thing, don't be stuck with these experiences. These are good. But as long as you see me as Swam, you have not had the ultimate truth. It's only you are growing. Maybe you can say, it's like a, if you see a boat, Bangalore, 60 kilometer. It's a good sign you are traveling on the right track. But it's not that Bangalore has come. So, don't stop near the signboards. Somebody is asking, do you have technology for converting Buddhas into Buddhas? What else you think I am doing now? See, if I call Buddhas into Buddhas, it looks very condescending. And I am telling people Buddhas. But even if I don't tell, truth is truth. So how many Buddhas have become Buddhas so far? I can't say. Less than 50. 50 I tried. Less than 50, at least 25. I can say at least 25. If you want to find out, I for some technical reasons I don't release the names. It creates a lot of complications for them, for their simple life. If you want to find out, try to live around the people who are living closely with me for last few years. You will be able to smell the same energy, the same intensity in them. Looking like me is not a thing. I don't. How do they look like me? I don't understand. Anyhow, he is not leaving me. As Tamil NSP, you have been in dining hall at least once a day. But here you don't turn at all into dining hall. We expect you at lunch. In Tamil NSP, I go and serve every day, at least once. He gave me yesterday also a letter, but somehow I avoided that letter today. All right, I'll write. One big problem in the programs conducted inside ashram, you know, one good positive thing, you have an energy field and the banyan entry and all those things. One bad thing is I am too much caught in so many things. The moment I go out of the hall, there will be 20 fellows standing for some instruction, report. That's the reason I am not able to come and serve in the dining hall. But at least I will try. Today I will try. And moreover, there I go and serve, because usually people get that stomach problems and they do this, all this Vada Pitta Kapha balancing. To heal the stomach, I energize the food so that they will all be healed. They will not have much problem. But here food is already energized. Every day it goes for offering. Please understand, all these 4 days you are eating the offered prasad, energized food. So nothing much, no, not much problem. Somebody is asking, I don't want to read their name, very personal question. After the prartha, or after the desire meditation, I know I have a deep lust, but I want to get rid of it, how to? I tell you, if it is your prartha, don't even bother about getting rid of it. You will see that lust has enough of power and capability, intensity. It will bring the right person to your life. See, understand, lust is not a dead energy. It's a living, intelligent, intense energy. Respect it. If it is agamya, it will die. If it is prarattha, which you brought, it will bring the right person to your life. And give you the deep fulfillment. And of course, beyond fulfillment, the bliss. So I don't think you should start working for suppressing or dropping. You should only bring more and more awareness to it. If it is agamya, it will drop. If it is prarattha, it will get fulfilled. Would you please explain the flowering of the emotional body when you are crying in joy? Is that it? When I think of sharing your meditation and teaching with others, I feel joy in my third chakra. Is the flowering or is it cleansing? It is flowering. In cleansing you won't feel joy. You will only feel peace. In flowering you will feel bliss. Let's enter into the initiation. Maybe just 2 minutes. We'll meditate and give our prayers and respects to all the great masters who developed this science of initiation into the truth and who preserve this truth on the planet Earth. Please close your eyes and sit straight. You don't have to like tie the ribbon. Just sit straight and close your eyes. Pray intensely to all of them to give you the experience of the truth. the initiation. Sadashiva samarampam Shankaracharya madhyamam Asmadacharya paryantam Vande guru paramparam. Understand this truth was transmitted only from being to being. You do not know which moment that truth will click with you. Don't miss even a single statement which I am uttering. Any moment it may click. It may just click with you. You may feel connected to these words, to the truth which I am uttering. First thing, I want to explain how you clutch, connect and create your so-called mind. Please understand, even if you have been initiated, even if you have been initiated already, do not bother. Listen intensely. You might have been initiated in any mantra, even the same initiation of unclutching, you might have heard. If you already done an NSP or Nityadhyan, you would have had this initiation. But don't think, you already had initiation. Just sit with a fresh beginner's mind. It can take you to the deeper level, clicks, deeper level, initiation. How you clutch and create your mind. Let me explain in a simple diagram, then you will be able to understand what I am saying. Usually, how you get thoughts and how it flows inside you. Your thoughts are different shape, different size, different length, different color, different frequency. They are all just flowing. They sometimes even overlap. Please understand, very important but basic truth about you, your mind, life. You can say one thought related to some joy and something is related to some suffering. Again, some joy, then again some suffering, some painful thoughts, then some joy thoughts, then some painful thoughts, some suffering. Like this, different thoughts are coming, mixing and mingling. Am I right? Please understand. Different thoughts are continuously flowing inside you. You are basically bundle of unconnected, illogical, independent thoughts. If you want to experiment, just you can take few minutes and pen down whatever is coming from inside. Please let me explain, then you can start doing it. Whatever comes inside, if you just pen down, you will understand there is no logical connection between one thought and other thought. For example, if you see a dog in the street,
immediately you will start remembering all the dogs which you have seen in your, when you were young, and the fear which you had, or the attachment you had for the pets. Then you will remember the young age, the teacher under whom you study. Then you will remember that place where the teacher stayed. Please understand, there is no logical connection between the dog which you saw on the street and the teacher under whom you studied in the young age. But suddenly the mind has slipped to, this is the way your mind flows. Even though both of them have barked at you, that is different. But there is no logical connection between the dog which you saw in the street and the teacher under whom you studied in the young age. But your mind just slips. You are nothing but a bunch of unconnected, independent, illogical, unclutched thoughts. Let us first understand this statement. This truth, let us understand. Let us experiment with it. Just sit now. Take up the paper and pen. Please understand. Pen down whatever goes on inside. If you feel like, no, I am not feeling like writing anything, I am feeling bored, write that also. Whatever goes on inside, ask it. Please listen. 1 minute. Please listen, then you can start. Have you heard this transcription softwares, the Dragon, the medical, all the doctors are using now. Doctors are using for medical transcription. The transcription software. Whatever you speak, it will transcribe. If a transcription software is connected to your mind, how it will transcribe? Without missing one sound, one word, don't edit, no grammar change, no phonetic change, no spelling change, no pronunciation change. Whatever goes on, just bend down. For a few minutes. Just for a few minutes. Please start.